Normally, when you want to add color to a line drawing, you select the brush you want, the color you want, and you do your best to keep that color inside the lines. The problem is that if you do it freehand this way, you usually have to go back and either erase the part outside of the lines, or maybe select the area you want to keep, then invert the selection, then do a three-finger swipe and delete the excess. But even this can lead to a less than perfect selection that isn't completely opaque from edge to edge and has missing gaps. A better way is to activate the selection tool at the top. Double check that you are in freehand selection mode at the bottom, then select the surface you want to fill and drag the color at the top right into the area of the selection to fill it. Once an area is selected, you can also open the layers menu. Tap the current layer to bring up the pop-up menu, then tap Fill Layer to fill the selected area with the current color and the color palette. You can also quickly select any rectangular area by tapping the selection tool, choosing Rectangle Selection Mode, picking a color, and then dragging the pencil from one corner to the opposite and filling in the color. If you accidentally cover up the underlined drawing, you can go back into the layer. Tap the little letter N that denotes blending mode, select Multiply Blending Mode, and your underlined drawing will reappear beneath the color. Working this way, you can quickly select and fill every surface of a drawing on its own layer, but you never have to worry if you got the color right the first time, because as long as each color is on its own layer, you can always go back in, make sure the layer is selected, tap the Adjustments menu icon, tap Hue, Saturation, and Brightness, and retroactively adjust the hue, saturation, or brightness of each individual color. Layers can also serve as placeholders of selected shapes, allowing you to use the Select command in the Layer pop-up menu to reselect the contents of a layer at any point in the drawing process, then either modify the layer itself or add a layer above to apply textures or gradients as overlays to the original layer without worrying about going outside the lines. Here I'm using the Nikki Roll brush to add a concrete texture over the base layer of the wall on the left. The select and fill technique also gives you at least three ways to add gradients to any selected shape on its own layer. The first is within the layer itself. In this method, select the contents of the layer in the Layer pop-up menu, then choose a brush and a color. Adjust the size and opacity of the brush to taste, and simply brush the color into part of the shape. You can switch to another color at any time to create a different part of the gradient. In the first example, I use the soft brush, but I can switch to any of the more painterly brushes, like this Bonobo chalk brush, to add a more textured effect to my gradients. The harder I push down on the tip of the Apple Pencil, the more textured the effect becomes. The second way to add a gradient to any shape is also within the layer itself, but this time using Pencil Mode of the Hue, Saturation, and Brightness Adjustments menu. To access this feature, tap on the Adjustment menu icon, then tap Hue, Saturation, and Brightness, then slide over to the middle of the top and tap on the pencil side of the menu. Next, select the pencil shape you'd like to use, then come to the bottom of the screen and adjust the sliders to set up what would you like your pencil strokes to change within the layer. This can be a little disorienting, as in this case, when I have intended to make the red darker, but the red is actually turning purple and not what I think of as a darker red. But not to worry, because once the strokes are made, I can still use any of the other sliders to further adjust the area I just altered with my pencil strokes. The third way to add a gradient to any layer is by adding the gradient to a new layer above the original layer. In this third scenario, select the contents of the layer in the usual way, then add a new layer above the layer you wish to alter. Next, select the brush and the color of your choice, and make the adjustments you want to make within the selected shape of the original layer. In the Layers menu, you can see these changes have all occurred inside the new layer without affecting the original layer. When you apply texture to a layer above the original layer, you not only protect the original layer, you also maintain your options to retroactively change the color of the texture itself, not to mention the blending mode, the opacity, or any other type of layer adjustment. For those of you who may wish to save time by filling in shapes as you select them, activate freehand selection mode, tap and activate the color fill icon at the bottom right, select the color you want, then simply begin drawing with the freehand tool. As you complete your selections, they will automatically fill in with the currently selected color. This can save a lot of time, but it is important to remember to turn off the colorful icon, or you may become very confused when you go to select a shape half an hour from now, and that shape fills up with color, and you don't know why. This idea of simultaneously drawing and painting as you go can be very handy when you don't mind a certain looseness in your sketches, as when I added this screen of trees to my sketch of the Villa Savoy, or when I added color to this freehand floor plan to add some basic shapes for furniture and to help differentiate one room from the next. For more Procreate and Morfolio Trace tutorials made just for architects and designers, check out the next video here and check out the iPad for Architects playlist I've made for users at all levels on the homepage of my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.